Agra, the location of the Taj Mahal, is also a spiritual center for a new religious tradition, the Radhasoami path. But it was here, in this area of Agra, that the movement was founded in 1861 by Swami Shiv Dayal Singh. Now, what happened since that time is an interesting story. For all the schisms and splinter groups and variant forms of belief that are found in Radhasoami's brief history are replications of what happens in the history of every religious tradition. Radhasoami history begins here in this house in a crowded area of Agra, and it has remained primarily an urban movement ever since. The first followers who gathered in this house in the 1860s were educated businessmen and government workers, and although they were modern people, they found a religious experience rooted in the medieval Hindu Sant tradition. In this house lived the first guru, Shiv Dayal Singh, known as Swamiji, who was son of a Punjabi banker of Khatri caste. His teachings are contained in this book of poetry and prose, written originally in Urdu, and entitled Sar Bhajan. He taught Shabd Bhakti, also called Sur Shabd Yoga, which has two central concepts, concentration on the names of the formless God and the union of each person's sound current with the eternal sound vibration. The idea of Shabd Bhakti Kabir, Ravi Das, and the other Sant tradition poet saints, found in the Adi Granth, the sacred book of the Sikhs. Swamiji's father was a Nanak Panthi, a Sikh, and Swamiji first attracted followers by teaching and interpreting the Adi Granth. Now, north of Agra, in the small town of Hathras, there was a local guru named Tulsi Sahib, of whom Swamiji's mother had been a devotee, and this may have accounted for another early influence in Swamiji's thought. We journeyed to Hathras, an all-day trip on a clumsy and erratic bus, to find out more about this Tulsi Sahib, whose teachings were said to have been influenced by an esoteric writing attributed to Kabir. A rickshaw wala knew the way through the back lanes to the temple where the present-day Sant continues Tulsi Sahib's line. Possesses a book written by Tulsi Sahib, a commentary on the Ramayana called the Gat Ramayana, which contains the sound current ideas. He also claims that Swamiji, as well as Swamiji's mother, had been one of Tulsi Sahib's initiates.
This of Agra, the first guru came and built this well and started teaching, and then later on they called this area Swami Bagh in honor of the first guru.
The site where the first guru meditated in the garden, a large temple is being constructed. It is being built much the way in which the Taj Mahal was built. For over 40 years and is being crafted by hand from marble imported from Rajasthan. It is actually a samad, a tomb for the remains of Swamiji, the first guru, who died in 1878. Instead of being cremated, as most Hindus are, gurus are often entombed after death. This samad and the relics of the original guru are in the possession of one Radhasoami faction, which did not allow other Radhasoami factions to visit the samad or venerate the relics, until a recent court order settled a long and bitter legal struggle in favor of the other factions. Samad is now open to all. It is half finished. The final plans call for a large dome to rest on top of a Gothic superstructure, rather as if a giant turnip were nesting on a cathedral. There are hopes that it will rival the Taj Mahal as a center of tourist attraction. Nearby Swami Bagh, there is another garden, a calmer garden, where the cremated remains of Radhaji, the wife of Swamiji, the first guru, are located. It is said that she also had spiritual powers and and she also served as a guru for some time after Swamiji's death.
The death of Swamiji created a crisis of leadership. There were four rival successors, but the primary one in Agra was Rai Selagram, who changed the organization of Radhasoami and perhaps gave it its name as well. Rai Selagram had been a high governor.
With regard to the name Radhasoami associated with this Sant Math organization known as the Radhasoami Sant.
After Rai Selagram, his three successors each took the Radhasoami teachings down differing paths. One of Selagram's successors was Shiv Bartlal, who took his followers with him to Benares. Shiv Bartlal taught a version of Radhasoami teachings which were closely compatible with the Sant tradition. But one of his successors, however, a Faqir Chand, took his followers to Hoshiarpur in the Punjab and changed the teachings considerably. Faqir Chand established a Manavta Mandir, a temple of humanity, where he taught the yoga of the sound current, but has renounced the external gurus, preaching the lesson through the guru within each person. He refuses to give initiation, so his organization is loosely knit, perhaps 100 persons.
Correct understanding of life. He who is bound with anyone, with his master, with wife, with anything, he never gets salvation.
Faqir Chand teaches Surat Shabad Yoga, but seldom uses the word Radhasoami. The main lineage from Selagram, however, was not through Bartlal and Faqir Chand, but through Brahm Shankar Misra, a Brahmin from Benares, who established a center at Allahabad. Misra had two groups of successors, both of whom eventually came back to the outskirts of Agra. One of these groups settled in Swamiji's garden. They are the ones building the huge temple in the Samad in honor of the first guru. This group, the Swamibha group, is the only functioning Radhasoami group which has allowed its lineage to die out. They have no living guru at present. Rather, their small, ingrown colony lives on the memories of the past. Swamibha is self-sufficient and middle class by and large, and contains a rather large number of Gujaratis. Some of the Swamibha group recognize an osteopath, Jayan Hazra, as their guru, and after his death, his daughter was also regarded as a guru. But for most of them, they are quite content to have no guru at all. The main group following Misra, however, was not Swami Bagh, but across the street from Swami Bagh, an arrival location they called Dial Bagh, also named after the first guru. Dial Bagh's present lineage continues, and the present guru, Dr. Lal, is former vice chancellor of Lucknow University. What made Dial Bagh special, however, is the fact that its colony of devotees created a modern industrial city. This guru, Anand Swarup, in 1915, established the colony of Dial Bagh as a place where devotees could live close to the guru and receive spiritual benefit. Many of the Radhasoami devotees who settled here came from Benares, from Bombay, and others from Tamil Nadu in South India. Six different Indian languages are taught in Dial Bagh schools. Those here are middle class and well-to-do, and they built the modern city. Now, the great expansion of Dial Bagh and its development as an industrial center came in 1937 with the next guru after Anand Swarup, Mataji, who had formerly been an engineer. Mataji had the vision of a modern industrial India, and he wanted that vision to begin with Dial Bagh. He established dairy herds, and he built large factories and educational institutions, training centers for both men as well as for women. Manufactured everything from handkerchiefs to hunting knives, scopes to toilet soaps. The major emphasis, however, was on leather goods and on text weaving. The largest of the textile mills was in Amritsar, but now that's fallen on hard times and has been taken over by the government. At the Heightens, they have their own network distribution center of stores throughout India. Now, who were the the remarkable leaders of this new industrial society. Many of them were retired businessmen and government officials. One of them, Baba Ram Jadown, who was general secretary for many years, had formerly been member of the Arya Samaj. Baba Ram Jadown explained that he and many of his friends in the Arya Samaj left the Arya Samaj when they felt it was getting too political and joined Radhasoami because they felt it created a modern society without losing many of the spirit's benefits.
Then you came to Radhasoami.
I was developing. The other lines of Radhasoami were developing as well. The largest of these was that following Jaimal Singh in the Punjab. Jaimal Singh was a Sikh. 6 years after Swamiji, the first guru, had died, he claimed that Swamiji had decreed him, Jaimal Singh, to take the teachings from Agra up to the Punjab. There he established a line of teachings, one of which followed Baga Singh, one of his disciples, to Pratap Singh in Taran, near. This line of Radhasoami teachings is very Sikhism. Baga Singh, the Radhasoami, is portrayed next to Guru Nanak, the founder of Sikhism. Pratap Singh, the Sant from Taran Taran, as he is called, is now aligned with the larger Vyas branch of Radhasoami. The Vyas branch of Radhasoami was founded by another of Jaimal Singh's, Sawan Singh, who is also called the Great Master. On the banks of the Vyas River, halfway between Jalandhar and Lahore, he founded a colony, a dera, which is called the Vyas Dera, in honor of Jaimal Singh, and he built a satsanga, a meeting hall there, also in honor of Jaimal Singh. Sawan Singh, the great master, was a remarkable man, and he made a number of significant changes in the Radhasoami organization, emphasized by the branches at Agra, and he taught 8 regions of sound and light through which the soul traveled on its way to the highest region. In his 35 years of leadership, he initiated 124,000 people into the Radhasoami faith. Many of them had been soldiers from the army. Others were common villagers, many of them lower caste people who sought out the Radhasoami movement for its sense of equality. Sawan Singh himself had been in the army. He was a military engineer, and he liked to design a number of buildings in the dera, including this one, the Satsangar, in honor of Jaimal Singh. After the great master's death in 1948, there were several rivals for his successorship, and probably the best known of those that were not established at Vyas was Kripal Singh. And since he could not stay at Vyas, Kripal Singh set up his own organization called Ruhani Satsang, and he established an ashram at Delhi called Sawan Ashram in honor of the great master.
And this is the home of Kripal Singh, who was one of the disciples of Sawan Singh. Kripal Singh started his own movement, the Ruhani Satsang, and this is his headquarters here, except that now the movement has fallen somewhat on hard times after his death.
After Kripal Singh's death in 1974, there are at least 3 rivals, one of them Darshan Singh, Kripal Singh's own son. Now, meantime, back at Vyas, the main line of the Vyas Radhasoami group was developing under the leadership of Jagat Singh, who reigned for only 3 years. Jagat Singh was a farmer chemistry teacher at Lyallpur Agricultural College, and his main contribution to Radhasoami teachings was the concept of science as a metaphor for spiritual development. Now, following Jagat Singh, the next guru at the Vyas branch of Radhasoami is Charan Singh, the present guru, who was the grandson of Sawan Singh. Charan Singh was trained as a lawyer, as a farmer. He's a modern guru who has enlarged the dera into something of a utopian city, who has internationalized the movement and brought Radhasoami teachings into encounter with other religious traditions.
stuff.
This we do it every day, Mithi Sheva, according to master order. Master order to do Sheva every day. This kills the man's ego, you see. Like we have to kill man's ego, so we have to do Mithi Sheva. From Japan with my family.
The organization of the Vyas branch is governed by an executive board which includes a judge, a former princess, and a member of parliament. This highly educated leadership corps that lives at the Vyas Dera and directs this organization are of Kshatriya caste, whereas the Gurus are generally of Jat Sikh caste. In addition, include a college president and a philosophy professor. You, for many years, were head of one of the largest universities in Punjab, and you were an active Sikh. How did you get interested in Radhasoami faith?
Because I felt that by reading scriptures, one could not actually go very far. It would not give me real satisfaction. And about 9 years ago, I felt that some spiritual practices are necessary if one is to know oneself.
I'm in charge of Vyas Publications, which publish hundreds of books and dozens of languages.
Superficially, people had that belief, and that was the superficial.
A former philosophy professor travels with Master Taran Singh when he travels abroad.
And professor of philosophy, how your family was in Radhasoami Satsang?
Well, I'm the youngest member of a large family. I have four brothers and a sister, and I think I had the advantage of learning or imbibing in the family whatever transpired there.
And they're all satsangis and they're all scholars, I think.
Actually, my second eldest brother first became satsangi here. And
a year on anniversary occasions for the great gurus, the stillness and quiet of the Vyas Dera is shattered by the invasion of over 100,000 devotees. Satsang worship service led by Master Taran Singh.
के हमारा पूरा संघ है पूरा फैमिली सत्संग है और हमको 6 साल हो गया नाम लेते हुए लेकिन अभी तक नाम नहीं दिया है हमको
महाराज के लिए
अखियाँ तरस रया दे दर्शन गुरु मेरे अखियाँ तरस रया दे दर्शन गुरु मेरे
प्रसाद है प्रसाद ये प्रसाद है
अच्छी बात
ये महाराज जी के प्रसाद हैं
which is a cost 1 rupee or 2 just to get a good meal. It's not free like the free langar over there, but it's still a very good buy. Now all of these stanchions along here during the big Bhandara days will be crowded with people, but it's terribly efficiently run because this way no one's pushing and shoving. Each person gets in their own separate line. कहाँ से आया लुधियाना से लुधियाना आपके काम क्या है
लुधियाना
और खेत काम कहाँ रहा है
खेती का
अच्छा here you are you work in the langar langar sevadar है अच्छा and your name is आपके नाम क्या है
हरिजन
अच्छा और कहाँ से आया
दिल्ली
और आपके काम
30 साल
अच्छा
दिल्ली
अच्छा और यहाँ आपके सेवदार
सेवदार
अच्छा
बहुत बजट बन रहा
अच्छा एंड वेयर डू यू कम फ्रॉम सर कहाँ से आया
मैं आया हूँ कानपुर
कानपुर
इधर आ जाओ
अच्छा और कानपुर में आपके काम क्या है
जनरल मर्चेंट नियर कानपुर
अच्छा और यहाँ
पर सेवा के लिए
अच्छी बात अच्छी बात मेहरबानी अच्छा लाल सिंह
कहाँ कहाँ से आया बटाला
Oh,
location for initiation is decided personally by Master Taran Singh. And then initiation take place in the days after the big Bhandara celebrations. Line up and Master Taran Singh nods yes they're in or no they're out. Initiation, receiving the secret five names, occurs soon thereafter. Job.
Hey, Kashmir, who is
this? This is Radhasoami.
Okay, and his name
is? Sasav Ra, Baba Radhasoami.
Okay, good.
And for them, Vyasa is something of a pilgrimage center. Westerners from South Africa, England, and America, the Radhasoami Vyasa Dera is something of a transnational culture. From abroad are given the comforts of home. I'm resident, Dr. Randolph Stone. Vyas, his own form of nature therapy called polarity therapy.
I left my country. All my belongings I sold away, gave away to friends, sold it away, really with the idea to go to India and to search out my guru. Staying in this country 2.5 years illegal. Only under Daiji's protection and Daiji's influence, I am saying.
You're going to become an Indian citizen?
Going to become an Indian citizen, huh? And according to our familiar mouth, living here, maybe forever, nobody knows. But I have no desire to return anywhere. Everything is here. When the Sam Sadhguru is here, everything is here.
You have to go to India to follow a Radhasoami. There are, for example, branch satsangs throughout the United States. David will be initiated by proxy in Los Angeles by a representative appointed for that purpose. North Hollywood, California. And you're, how old now?
22.
Right. And how many years have you been applying for initiation?
About 4.5. Mm-hmm. It was about 1974, I first applied.
Uh-huh. And you wrote to the Dera?
I wrote to the Dera, and I didn't get a letter back from my second letter I got back.
Uh-huh.
From Bhatnagar, secretary of Dera.
Right.
And he said, wait for the right age. And then I continued to...
What's the right age?
22.
Uh-huh.
For males. And I think it's 20 for women.
Uh-huh. And now you're 22?
22, and I wrote for initiation about a month and a half back.
And?
And I had just been accepted 2 weeks ago.
Congratulations.
Well, thank you.
And when are you going to be initiated?
November 26th.
How do you feel about it?
Very, 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 very good.
Terrific.
Very good.
When
Satsang? You go to Satsang regularly?
In the San Fernando Valley, we have a couple.
How many?
There's only one. What happened was divided coastally, in the valley, and now downtown Los Angeles. And there's one in Glendale, Pasadena.
How many people go there?
I would say roughly about 50 people.
Mm-hmm. All different ages?
All different ages. Mostly it tends to be older people.
Huh.
Tends to be.
Uh-huh.
And I would say that especially in Los Angeles area.
Mm-hmm.
Coast area gets a little younger too.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel closer to people there than to ordinary people? Or?
Well, we just all have that kind of bond because we all follow the master. It's that kind of unifying.
Uh-huh.
So when you see a satsang, it's just like somebody's your brother because we all follow that same ideal, that same truth.
Right. Mm-hmm. And you're all vegetarian?
All vegetarians. And that kind of makes it seem like you either talk about food or you talk about math.
You can't even eat eggs.
No, you don't even eat eggs or fish or anything that contains the essence of
the mm-hmm. Is it difficult to find food?
Some places it is. Some places. Los Angeles is not very difficult. But I think out of state places may be more difficult.
Mm-hmm.
New York.
Mm-hmm.
But in Los Angeles. Mm-hmm.
Swami path has become splintered and buried and transformed by new ideas and new kinds of people since its inception in 1861. The core of the teachings remain essentially true to Swami Shiv Dayal Singh, Swamiji, and to the Sant tradition.
Awesome.